Hello, I'm Gavin Hoey and this is another 15 minute photo challenge. Well, today I've come down to the seaside. It's a gloriously sunny April's day. I'm going to spend 15 minutes here, looking around here, trying to find photos, trying to make photos, and let's see what we can come up with. So, well, time's getting away, so let's get cracking. Here we go. This is what we're looking for. This lovely, lovely texture is precisely what I'm after. Should be really nice indeed, just to try and pick up these little bits of texture. And we'll put the aperture, well, I'm going to put the aperture on f11 to try and get the best quality out of the lens. I don't need a big depth of field because these are pretty flat, but nonetheless, I want to get the best from the lens that I can. And in this bright sunny weather, well, we bump the ISO up a little bit to 400. It's going to give me a shutter speed of 200th of a second. So 200th of a second is enough to get things sharp. And if you've seen my work before, you'll know I'm going to make the most of that texture. I'm going to chuck a bit of a vignette around it. I'm going to bring up the clarity, bump up the vibrance. I can see it in my head already. This is kind of fun. It's obviously been burnt through here at some point. So what we might be able to do is actually use this as a natural frame, try and frame what's behind it through it. Okay, let's have a little go. Okay, so here's a little trick we could try. We're going to take two shots. I'm going to take one where I've got this in focus. I'm going to take a second one where I've got the background out in focus. The background's miles and miles away. The aperture just isn't working for me. So I'm then going to use Photoshop to bring the two together. That's the idea. Right, let's see what else we can find. There's lots of little pebbles and bits just jammed into bits of wood. So I'm going to try and get some of these. And what have we got? Well, we've got some pebbles. I don't mind helping nature along a little bit here either. So I'm just going to grab a few of these. Just put a few in there like that. Let's find one colourful one. Maybe just a few other bits and pieces. Looks like it that. Okay. There we go. Super. Okay, now this time rather than using a small aperture to try and get everything in focus, I'm going to use a huge aperture, the biggest one I can, f4, to try and put everything out of focus other than the very small part, just the small bit. I just want this little rock in focus here. Here we go. Okay, and the sun's just gone in as well, so that's going to help too. That's going to give it a much more even illumination on here, take out some of those bright highlights. Okay, let's go. Okay, well, I'm going to go up the top. You stay there. Need something red, need something warm to go on top of this great big lump of wood. 1 second. Okay, there we go, very small red rock placed on top. What you can't see from down there is the top of this piece of wood is all cracked and weathered, and we've got the tree rings as well. So plonk that right on the top. Red stone contrasts with the woody colour. Let's see what we can get. Okay. Oh yeah. Here we go. Oh! I've got time for one more quick one. Literally just walking past, here is a little bit of green rope tied or got attached to this rusty old nail. So bit of colour, bit of rust, bit of decaying and weathered wood. Oh, come on, it's got to be a photographer's shot, isn't it, really? Let's see if we can help it along a little bit. Let's let that down carefully. We'll just try and wrap that in. Something like that. Try and keep it nice and flat. There we go. That looks good. Nice and flat. Ah, oh, and the sun's coming out as well. Perfect timing. You know what? I was shooting the close-up there as well, and I thought that looked pretty good, but I've just zoomed out a little bit. It actually looks quite good as a wide shot, too. Really good idea to take both close-up and wide shots of any subject, because you may not get to see it again. Okay, there we go. All done. Bang on time as well. So, there you have it. That's our 15-minute photo challenge wrapped up. Now, unusually, I can't actually see the pictures on the back of the camera because of the really bright sunshine. So, I'm praying that I have some good pictures on here. You've already seen them. I've not, but I'm going to run them through Photoshop and see what I can do with them. So, I'm Gavin Howie, thanks for watching.